Happy New Year, MTP number 44. And it's wonderful to have you here today. And it's been an exciting year. It's been an impeachment year, and it's been a lot to talk about when it comes to politics, but we're not gonna talk about politics today. We're gonna talk about what I've heard all year long. And despite the fact that Alfie and I were discussing this, I do believe there's been a couple of MTPs where we've addressed size. So we're gonna talk about penis size. And the title of this talk will be Penis Size Times 3, because I wanna drive it into your heads. First thing that I wanna go over is the reality of penis size and erectile dysfunction. And I always quote this one paper that was written by my alma mater, University of Miami, where they looked at guys who were rendered impotent by a radical prostatectomy, and they followed their loss of penile size over the course of about a year and a half. Let's just say a year and a half. Now, the reality was that everybody lost size. Nobody didn't lose size. So hear me out. So if everybody loses size after they've been rendered impotent, what's going on? And we can go back to some of Tom Liu, who's a guy from UCSF who writes some brilliant stuff that looking at the microbiology of this. But once you render the penis without as much oxygen, because you're not getting nocturnal erections, you end up with fibrosis, or scarring of the erectile body. So fibrosis of the corporal bodies leads to what? Corporal atrophy leads to loss of penis length and girth. That's just a simple reality. Now, how much do you lose? And the paper that I like to quote and what I teach people to come down here is you're gonna lose somewhere between 0.5 and 5 centimeters over the course of about a year and a half. 5 centimeters on a penis is like 40 to 50 feet on a boat. Think about it. It's the difference between a tender and a yacht. All right, so if everybody that has erectile dysfunction, everybody loses length and girth, then what can we expect when we put in a penile implant in a guy? Now, there's no algorithm for looking at how long you've been impotent and how short your penis is gonna be other than this, but you know, it varies depending upon what kind of rehab you've been trying to do or whether you have or haven't, you know, been trying to do other treatments. But the reality is you need to go into a penile implant understanding that every day that you remain impotent, you're going to be losing length and girth. I've quoted, and I know in the past, I don't know which MTP, one of our abstracts where we looked at what we can predict a guy's going to have at the time of surgery. Now, I want you to listen to this very carefully. If you pull on your penis in a hot shower as hard as you possibly can, it's going to be the same length as an erection that I would provide for you on the day of your surgery, and it's going to be the same thing that you would get when I put a penile implant in you. Now, I talked about impeachment for a second because there's certain people in my realm that like to sit in a circular firing squad and sort of shoot each other off instead of trying to build, you know, our craft from the inside. And you will have people that will tell you that one procedure makes a penis shorter than another. That's all garbage. It's all complete garbage. You need to understand that a penis is a penis is a penis when you bring it into us. Whether we do a subcoronal, an infrapubic, a penoscrotal approach, you're going to have the same length. Now, some of us will push on our sizing, and there's a certain point where you don't want to oversize more than you already are. And this is all something that you learn as you develop your craft. So what I'm trying to tell you is what you got today is what you're gonna have if you get surgery. What you got today is because you have or have not waited, you know, to do something about your erectile dysfunction. What you have, there's no snake oil out there that's gonna make things better. The reality is erectile dysfunction leads to loss of penile length and loss of penile girth. There is no approach that's any better than the others. That's a bunch of garbage. I'm telling you, it doesn't matter if one of my friends does a penis quota or I do an infrapubic, it's gonna be the same penis. What you need to understand is every day that you wait, it gets shorter and skinnier. And that's kind of a depressing message for 2020. But the good message is, if you get treated, you will be able to get some of your length and girth back. And you gotta go to MTP 21. What do you think, Alfie? I think it's 21 or 22, one of those. And it will talk to you about how to rehabilitate your penis once you have a penile implant in place. So This, I hope, will stop all the questions from 2019 that I thought I addressed when it comes to penile size. Stop listening to snake oil. Stop reading the conspiracy theories on the internet. Don't look at InfoWars. All right, so you know where I'm coming from. It's been a great year. 2019, 2020 is going to be better. Great. Bye.